Hi, this is Justin from OSI Affiliate Software, and in today's video, we're going to be looking at Bigcommerce, and we're going to be going over the very basics of Bigcommerce, including how to add a new product and managing your categories. So let's go ahead and get started. First thing that we'll notice is that we already have 44 products, even though I just signed up for an account. Basically, what Bigcommerce does is they add in a few sample products to your store. Basically just so that you can see what it's going to look like. So if I go ahead and click on View Store, we've got a basic template already set up, as well as a couple of images right here and some products. But what we're going to do is we are going to delete all of these products. So what I can do is either click on Products right here or go to Products and View Products. Okay, so I'm on the View Products page, and we've got three pages of products. So I'm going to click on View and go to just 100 so we can view all the products at one time. And I'm going to check all of them and hit the Delete button. And once I hit OK, they will be removed from my site. I'm also going to completely redo the categories. So once again, I'm going to click on Products and go down here to Product Categories. And what I can do is select all of these and once again delete them. Okay, so now that's done, let's go ahead and add a new product. So I'm going to click on Products again, and this time I'm going to click on Add a Product. So just as an example, I have a shoe store. This particular shoe is going to be a Nike running shoe. So we can give it any name we want. Now, just for this example, we're going to be basing it off of this shoe right here, the Nike Free 3.0 Flyknit. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that in as the name. Now for the price, I can choose really any price I want. We're going to go with $139.99. That's before tax. Now this is a physical product, and we can put in the weight right here. So I'm going to put in 2 pounds. And now we have the description. I highly recommend filling out this description, as this will really help with customers looking at the product, as well as search engines. Now this is a complete editor here, so we could, for instance, bold running, or we could change the font family to one of these options that we have here. So I could change it to Verdana. I could make the font size, say, like a little bit bigger. We could even add a link, just have a link to Nike's website. There's tons of things you can do here. I can even put in a YouTube video if I'd like to, but let's keep going. Here we have shipping. I could turn on free shipping if I wanted to. We're not going to mess with shipping right now, as it's really going to depend on how your commerce site is set up. So we're just not going to mess with that right now. And as far as availability, we're just going to keep it at this product can be purchased in my online store. Oh, you know, I did forget something. Here at categories, we need to create a new category. So we're going to call this men's running shoes. There we go. And once we have created the category, we'll hit save and click on the checkbox right next to men's running shoes, and it will be placed in that category. So now let's go to images and video. Here we can find images and video that will promote the product, kind of show what it does. We can even put in a YouTube video if we have the URL. Okay, so what I can do is select an image from my computer, and we'll go ahead and select that image of the shoe itself. And we can add a description to this particular image. I'm not going to do that right now. And really, that's basically all we need to do. There are several other things you can do, but that's really more of an add-on, things you don't necessarily have to do. For instance, on options, this would be good if you would like to add different sizes, which is pretty important for shoes, but it might not be important for your products. We also have custom fields, Google Shopping, if you want to set up a Google Shopping account with this. We can go over here to other details, like warranty information, different search keywords, which could actually be pretty important for improving your SEO. We can also go over here to bulk pricing, so you can set up bulk pricing with your product. But for now, what we're going to do is click on save. Now it is giving me a warning because I have not entered all of the physical dimensions. Obviously, that is something you're going to have to do depending on your product, but we're going to hit continue. Now we can go back to our store, standard sneakers, and simply refresh the page. And once we click on men's running shoes, it's going to show our one product that we have. And we can go ahead and click on it and look at the options and all that stuff. Now, like I said, these are the options that you'll need to configure. Basically, what you'll have to do is add each version of the product for all the colors that you're going to offer, and also all the sizes that you're going to offer. Another thing that you'll notice is that our store, we haven't really customized the look at all. In fact, these two images right here are just what Bigcommerce gave us. So what we're going to do is customize the look and feel of our website. So what you're going to do is go and click on design right here. And basically, this is going to allow you to change your theme. Now, you can make your own theme and upload it to Bigcommerce, or what you can do is choose a theme from Bigcommerce themselves. Now, as you can see, there are some paid themes, but if you keep going down, there are some that are quite a bit cheaper. So if you see a theme that you like, you can click on View Demo. This is a little bit like what it would look if your site was completely filled out. Mine isn't right now. I'm gonna keep looking at the themes. So what we can do is let's try this one. This is the classic theme. And you know what? I think this one would really work well with my shoe website. So I'm gonna go ahead and click apply on this classic theme. And now it is up, so we can refresh. And as you can see, the changes have been applied. Now if we go back, there's more things that we can change. For instance, the logo right here. And right now my logo is really just my name. And I'm gonna keep it at that just because I don't have a logo ready, and this is really an easy way to have a logo, you could say. But if you wanted to, you could upload from your computer. If you go over here to mobile, I do have a mobile theme enabled right now. I'm gonna keep this how it is. And on here, the carousel, this is where I can change these images right here that are showing up here. So if I had a nice big image of, you know, some of my shoes or some kind of promotion, this is where I would change it. You can also change what text goes right here. So I could say men's shoes, and it will change, and you know, I could change this to, you know, change up to 25% off the latest styles. You can also change the color, and of course the image back here. Down here you have your social icons. So let's say I don't have, for instance, a LinkedIn account. I could go ahead and get rid of it and put Tumblr there instead. Now if we scroll back up here to more, there's some other things we can change. But once you've got that set up, your store is pretty much good to go. Now there are a whole lot of small things you can do, but right at this point you do have a lot of the basics down, and you should be able to start selling your first products. I hope you enjoyed this video. This has been Justin from OSI Affiliate Software. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure to check out our other videos about e-commerce marketing. And if you are looking for videos on how to market your Bigcommerce store, click on the link below.